The Bible say, then the beast was permitted to wage war against the saints and to conquer them, and it was given authority over every tribe and people and tongue and nation, and all who dwell on the earth will worship the beast, all whose names have not been written from the foundation of the world in the book of life belonging to the Lamb who was slain. If anyone is destined for captivity, into captivity he will go. If anyone is to die by the sword he must be killed. Here is a call for the perseverance and faith of the saints. Since 2020 began, the greatest plan in history is underway to bring the mark of the beast, and the plan began by convincing everyone in the world that he had to wear a mask. What does it mean to wear a mask? It means you no longer have an identity, because with a mask you can't know who you really are. This is not all the factions of the face. This mask means you no longer have an identity, you no longer have a voice or vote, and that democracy will come to an end very soon, and people will no longer be voted as the presidents. Did you know that democracy is about to disappear? The word says he was given authority over every tribe, people, language and nation. There will be a one world president coming soon, and all the presidents of the earth will surrender their power, their authority to the beast. They will freely hand over their armies and they will hand over their savings to the beast that will rule the whole world. Everyone of the elite has agrees and is ready. The government of Israel disagree with Donald Trump ideology. They do not want him in power because he is fighting against the empire of the beast that is settling on the earth. Israel despised Jesus Christ. They have hated Christ and they are asking for a new Messiah. Israel has turned its back on God and his son Jesus Christ, and they don't want Donald to stay in power. They want to begin to establish the new world order, where all the governments of the earth will agree to. There is no more democracy in voting, but now there is only one world government. They call this pandemic a serious crisis. Therefore the solution is the Great Reset. Since 2020 onward there is a diabolical plan being unveiled now, and it has already begun. They are tearing down everything they call the old world. The new way of ruling is now establishing itself. In 2021 there is gonna be the biggest wave, and terrible things will come to Mexico and all the earth. So get ready, brother, in fasting and prayer and in provisions, buying corn and saving cash. In truth I don't know if we will be able to buy and sell. I don't know if it will not be possible. If you don't believe and don't want to understand and walk in what God is saying, you will suffer. Right now we enjoy many things, but you must understand the danger is ahead. I spoke with a brother from Venezuela and I asked him, how are you guys over there? He said, they have us up to annex, we are drowning in Venezuela. The control that comes over the whole world is going to start in the USA, because they want to bring America to an end, establishing new norms. They don't want the people to choose their rulers. I'm going to tell you what is going to happen. What is going to happen is that the curfew is going to be imposed first, so no one can leave, saying that only one person per family can go shopping and nobody else. We don't know if they will receive 2 out of 3 in the stores. We are running out of time. Brother, get food that you can keep for long time. Time is running out very fast. Don't buy perishable food. I bought things that are not damaged in few days. Times are going to get complicated very fast, especially in cities, because the government doesn't want the people of God. The scripture say he was allowed to wage war against the saints and defeat them, but some of the saints says this is talking about the Great Tribulation. In truth it is talking about the persecution that the church will face on earth. I also wish the church was not on earth. I also want the rapture to happen earlier, even tomorrow, so we can go with Christ and escape all these evil that is coming. I saw a large field when I was praying to the Lord and saying, Lord, show me what is going to happen. The Lord showed me a field. The Lord said the harvest is plentiful, but the workers are few, and he told me, don't worry, son, because we will only harvest those who are mature servants. The crybabies will not enter, the complainers, the criticizing tongue, the troublesome will not enter, brother. The wheat and the tares are all mixed, but finally we are entering the time of the separation of the wheat from the tares. Now we are entering time where you are going to see who is an authentic believer and a false. The day has come, brother, where we will all be tested in front of the military personnel and persecution. It's easy to be a Christian today, but days are looming when our faith will be tested. We will see those who claim to be Christian and are not. These hypocrites will be exposed. A good tree cannot bear bad fruit, and a bad tree cannot bear good fruit. Every tree that does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire. So then by their fruit you will recognize them. Our faith has not reached its limit. Until our faith is tested to its limit, we will not be able to distinguish the wheat and the tares. I'm also a Christian, and I also want to be thrown out with the brothers. I am ready to be locked up for my Lord. What do I want life for? I want to go with the Lord in the rapture in the cloud. Our faith, brother, right now is not yet tested to the limit. But what would happen when our faith is put to the limit, where we can no longer take it anymore? Are you sure you will go on? I want to tell you that no one will find the word rapture in Apocalypse. Many are comforting themselves saying that the apocalypse happen when the church leaves the earth. The issue is that people think that we are escaping apocalypse. Thus none is waiting for persecution. Everybody is waiting for the rapture. In truth, we should have been anticipating persecution first, before even thinking about the rapture. It is because of this mentality that say rapture first that no one is waiting for apocalypse. I believe, my brother, that persecution will come first, and it will become so intense before the rapture that we will hear the sound of the trumpet. Because you have kept my command to persevere, I will also keep you from the hour of testing that is about to come upon the whole world, to test those who dwell on the earth. I am coming soon. Hold fast to what you have, so that no one will take your crown. The test and persecution is coming. Do not fear what you are about to suffer. Behold, the devil is about to throw some of you into prison, that you may be tested, and for 10 days you will have tribulation. Be faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. It is through this test that the wheat and tares will separate it. My brother, this is the harvest time. The Bible say, let both grow together until the harvest. And at the time of harvest I will say to the reapers, first gather together the tares and bind them in bundles to burn them. But gather the wheat into my barn. Beloved, do not be surprised at the fiery trial when it comes upon you to test you, brothers. Test is looming in the horizon. I believe truly that harvest time has come. This is the time of separation of wheat from the tares. Because the one that is wheat has to prove that he loves Jesus. All the apostles died in a terrible and tragic way. Their faith was tested and was proven. If you want to be an apostle of Jesus Christ, you must be prepared to die as one of them. Not like those false apostles. They claim to be apostles but they are nothing. You want to be a true servant of Jesus Christ, you must be prepared for the test that is coming to this world, and you will be tested to the limit, and you must be willing to die as one of the true servants of Jesus Christ. If you are an hypocrite, you will see that you are not prepared for that. There are still women who say to the Lord, I want to have a baby, but God will not give them, because they don't know what they ask. For the time that is coming will be terrifying. It will be frightening. It will be terror. I don't really know if we will be able to bear what is coming. You claim to be a Christian. Brothers have not realized that already the time of the great evangelical campaigns have gone. Times of public crusade are already finished. We are not in that time. We are in the time of hiding, where the government is going to come against churches. So prepare yourself in fasting and prayer. Build the altar where you will come to pray and cry and prepare with oil. This is not a game. It will be tough to be a Christian. Where we are heading, it will require a lot of dedication and sacrifice to be a Christian. It will be a true proof of God's love is in us. How many are prepared for the scenario where we can no longer buy or sell? Are we really prepared? Look at all those who like money. They will be marked. Exchange your money for food. Get ready urgently. Your mind is not on what the Lord says. I have read here the passage that says, here is the patience and the faith of the saints. Apocalypse 14 verse 12, says here is the patience of holy those who keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus. And I heard a voice from heaven tell, I can see the brothers are maturing little by little in this church. They are not as they were before. They know how to bend their pride. Now they are humble. They are already preparing to face coming hunger and persecution that is looming, and then to go with Christ in the rapture. Because of all these diabolical laws against God are on the way, children. Just like honey is ripening, just like the wheat is already preparing to be cut from the ground. How many want to be cut from the earth? Just as the wheat is already preparing to be cut to the ground, There is also the children of Satan. They are also the Satan's servants. The enemy hates this time where he will be cast in the great winepress of the God's wrath. The elite no longer want America to be well. Now they want the America to bend to be broken. The earthly Israel is have turned their back on God. The temple in Israel is being prepared for the Antichrist. He will says tremendous things and opened his mouth in profanity against God to blaspheme his name and his tabernacle. He's going to sit there and say profanity. The real Israelite is those who will not deny their faith to the Lord, but things will go very fast. 2020 started it all. They are going to establish a satanic way of ruling, where there will no longer be freedom. It's easy to control people just telling them we can sell you this, but you need a special register where you are registered. You should have made a provision of cane food, to prepare for the terrible days to come, but you don't have your head on prophetic warning that God is issuing. Your head is distracted, you are not serious with God and with prophecies, thus you will suffer. We will all suffer at the end of the day. But to see your little ones and not having something to feed them, you are going to be the first to fall, because you are not prepared mentally, neither spiritually, nor with food nor with grains to feed them. When curfew starts, it's gonna be terrible. We do not know at what degree we are going to face this apocalypse as the Antichrist is stepping into scene. Look, brother, the governments no longer want democracy. They no longer want the people to choose their rulers. Those who are in the governments have already delivered the place to the Antichrist. Israel now wants the Antichrist to come more than ever. They don't call him Antichrist, they call him the Messiah, the Anointed One. In